This presentation is for educators who are preparing to utilize the writing to respond process in their classrooms. It will be divided into three sections. Section 1 presents the resources for easy implementation of the process. Section 2 presents the process. And Section 3 deals with how to prepare for teaching the process. The resources. The most important resource to you as an educator is the Educator Wheel. This tool presents the role of the educator throughout the teaching process. It presents the steps of the writing to respond process from the educator's perspective, the framework for teaching the process, and how to prepare for teaching the process. The next resource is the classroom chart. This tool serves as a visual aid to present the process orally in the initial stages. There are three charts, one for oral responses, one for beginning writers, and one for advanced writers. There are two texts, Writing to Respond, Cultivating a Habit, recommended as a teacher resource for grades K through 5, and Writing to Respond to Text and Tests, recommended for grades 6 through 12 as a students and teacher resource. Both books entail detailed explanation of the writing to respond process, teacher models, student samples, rubrics, and exercises. The Student Wheel is a succinct version of the books. It presents the elements of the process and tips for tackling writing on tests. This tool is recommended for grades 3 and up. The workbooks present rubrics, graphic organizers, and opportunities for differentiation among learners. It serves as a tool for measuring progress. There is one for grades K through 12, one for grades 3 through 5, and one for grades 6 through 12. Section 2, the process. The writing to respond process entails three major elements that guide students on how to interact with information or literary text. They are identify, summarize, and react. First, students identify the key elements of text, the author, the title, and the publication. The depth of this information varies for grade or educational level. This aspect is important, as it takes care of intellectual integrity or avoiding plagiarism. The second element of the process is summarizing. Students learn to summarize and to differentiate between summarizing and paraphrasing and interpreting. It is important that educators are vigilant at that phase and ensure that students do not engage in retelling. The most important aspect is reaction. This is the time when students begin to provide analysis, evaluative or synthesis responses, and they provide evidence from the text or form previous experiences to support their responses. K through 5 students are asked to express their feelings or to respond to teacher-directed higher-order thinking questions. They are given opportunities to ask questions for clarification and to solve problems arising from the text. Grades 6 through 12 utilize teacher or student-formulated higher-order questions to guide their responses. Their responses may be one or a combination of analysis, evaluation, or synthesis. This depends on teachers' discretion based on students' educational level or classroom writing focus. The end goal to present sentence responses into paragraph form. This stage can progress based on grade level or teacher's discretion. Section 3. This section can be considered the most important. It deals with how to prepare for teaching the process. Pay close attention to the educator wheel as all these elements are detailed on the wheel. First, consider selecting the right reading materials, taking into consideration students' interest, grade and educational level, and text complexity. Next, identify the college and career-ready grade level standards. Then, focus on the strategies that you will employ during the process. For example, close reading, summarizing, and in-text citation are useful, but are only a few of the techniques that may be utilized. There is also a framework or suggested method for teaching the WTR process. Give clear instructions through modeling, provide good examples and several opportunities for practice. Be sure that students have easy-to-use rubrics found in workbooks and texts. Provide timely feedback and provide opportunities to share. This is only a succinct preparation for implementation. Email Dr. Watts at buttonwriters@gmail.com with your questions. Do not make the writing to respond process a burden. It is meant to encourage critical and analytical thinking in everyday teaching. Focus on cultivating the habit in your students. They will develop mastery and the result will resonate in their academic performance and on their test scores. Thank you for your time.